This video shows how to configure an auto-scalable cluster for Liberty Elasticity. With Liberty Elasticity, you have autonomic starting and stopping of cluster members based on scaling policies and resource use, just like with JVM Elasticity. But you also have autonomic provisioning of new cluster members to other hosts. Even if a host doesn't have a Liberty profile installed, Liberty Elasticity can autonomically install on that host what's called a stack of Liberty software, the Liberty Profile Runtime, an IBM JRE, and a Liberty server with your applications, and then autonomically start and stop those installed Liberty servers and their applications. This gives you greater capacity to handle spikes in resource demand. What you see here is a scaling controller provisioning a stack group of Liberty software to host registered with the controller when resource use goes up, and then stopping or starting the provisioned cluster member servers and their applications in response to resource demands. You determine what Liberty software needs to be in a stack group based on what Liberty software is available on a registered host. I begin by creating a server. At the WLP bin directory of my Liberty profile installation, I run the server create command and name the server my controller. To make this server a collective controller, I run the collective create command. The command by default writes output to a console screen. You can specify the create config file option to write the output to a file instead. I copy the output and paste it into the server XML file of my controller. I specify admin user and admin password for the controller administrator username and password. I add host equals asterisk to the HTTP endpoint element. This is optional. To make my controller a scaling controller, I add the scaling controller -1.0 feature to a feature manager element. I also add the Admin Center -1.0 feature so I can view my collective in Admin Center. And finally, add a scaling policy. I begin with a scaling policy that is disabled and has a minimum and maximum of one server. To start my controller, run the server start command at a WLP bin command line. To view my controller in Admin Center, open a browser on the controller hostname controller port number admin center URL. If your browser prompts you to confirm that the connection is trusted, specify an exception or otherwise enable the connection to admin center. Go to the Explore Tools Servers page. I now make a scaling member. At a WLP bin command prompt, I run the server create command and name the server my member. To join this server to the collective, I run the collective join command. You can get the host, port, user, and password values from the controller server XML file. For keystore password, set a value to use for the member keystore password. The hostname parameter is optional. I now copy the output and paste it into the my member server XML. You can specify the create config file option to write the output to a file instead. In the member server XML file, I set the RPC user and password, which are the username and password that I enter to log on to this Windows computer. The user must have administrative privileges on the computer. In this example, the controller and member are on the same host, so I need to change the port numbers. If your member server is on a different host from the controller, ensure the ports are unique on that host. Add the scaling member -1.0 feature to make the member server a scaling member. Add a host singleton element and set its port to a number that is unique on the host. The host singleton port is used by all Liberty servers on the same host to elect a leader. The job of the leader is to report aggregated scaling metrics for all servers on the host. If the leader stops running, another leader is elected. Start my member. I want to test the autoscaling. In the controller server XML file, I enable the scaling policy and save the file. At this time, the configuration has JVM elasticity. The scaling controller can start and stop scaling members based on scaling policies and resource use. Because I haven't yet set up the configuration for Liberty Elasticity, I disable the scaling policy. In the member server XML file, I add a statement that puts the member in a cluster named mystackgroup.cluster1. I'm going to make the mystackgroup directory and put installables and packages for Liberty Elasticity autoscaling into it. You can use the default stack group name, default stack group. Cluster 1 is the name of the server package that I'm going to make. If your collective has other dynamic cluster members, add the same statement to the other member server XML files so they belong to the same cluster. I want Liberty Elasticity autoscaling to install Cluster 1 on a different host. I run the collective register host command and specify a Linux machine for the target host. You can run additional register host commands and register more than one target host. If the registered host has no Liberty software, which is the case here, then the stack group needs to contain a Liberty profile runtime, IBM JRE, and a Liberty server package with applications. I'm now going to create the mystackgroup directory. This directory name is the same as what's in the cluster name. I copy the default stackgroup directory and rename it. I'll be putting Liberty software that I want the scaling controller to install on the registered host in the installables and packages subdirectories. To create a Liberty runtime archive, I run the server package command with the include equals WLP option. This creates an archive that contains the WLP directory, but does not contain the user directory. The archive name, WLP.855.zip, follows the naming convention. Copy the archive to the stackgroup installables directory. To create an IBM JRE that supports Liberty servers, zip up the contents of the Java directory of the JRE used for Liberty profile. Move the archive to the stackgroup installables directory. To create the Cluster 1 server package, create a server named Cluster 1. Add one or more applications to it. And run the server package Cluster 1 command with the include equals user option. This creates a server package that contains the user directory, but does not contain all the Liberty runtime files. Copy the zip file to the stackgroup packages directory. In the controller server XML file, add a statement that sets the username and password for the stack manager. I'm now ready to test the Liberty Elasticity autoscaling. I can force the scaling controller to provision the Liberty software to the registered host by increasing the min and max values and enabling the scaling policy. After I save the changes, I wait for Admin Center to display the provisioned member server. As you can see, the scaling controller installed a cluster 1 member on the registered host, then started the member and its application. Liberty Elasticity autoscaling is working, so I set the min and max values to what I want for the autoscaling. The provision member will start and stop based on scaling policies and resource use. The registered host now has the WLP, WLP.JRE, and WLP.User directories for the Liberty Runtime and JRE installables and Cluster 1 server package. For more information about autoscaling and Liberty Profile, see wasdev.net and the Liberty Profile documentation on IBM Knowledge Center.